Hello peeps! Today I want to talk about the main flying jobs in TT and as a fitting bonus about trains. I will go over these jobs in general and how to level them as fast as possible. So we're gonna talk about airline pilot, cargo pilot and heli pilot, then about the heli and train conductor EXP token big brain strategy, and after that about the train conductor jobs, which is metro, passenger train and cargo train. Some topics in this guide are also mentioned in my progress video, so I will try not to repeat as many things, but I also want to explain the job for my first time viewers, so sorry if you need to hear some things twice. Compared to the moneymakers in my progress guide, the payment of airline pilot is way lower and the payment of train conductor is basically non-existing. Keep in mind that you will need to get a little bit of money to buy the airplanes required to get to these maximum levels, which can be quite expensive at the start, so I wouldn't really recommend airline or cargo pilot as a starting job. Your biggest income in these jobs will come from selling the EXP tokens to other players over the marketplace or Discord, with airline being one of the most asked tokens as you unlock a sexy Concorde for 1 million experience. Every stop you get EXP tokens, and the best strategy is to convert them into bonus XP tokens directly. These bonus XP will be consumed the next time you get experience for that job. This rule of always converting them is used in basically every job besides helicopter pilot and train conductor, so that's why I put those together in one video. All aircraft are available at the dealership in SSIA, LSIA and MGA airport, as well as your faction if they purchase the dealership for it. This part will probably be the most skipped one of the video, but I still wanna go over them so you are safe on the server and not get unnecessarily kicked or timed out or anything like that. Your airplane is only allowed on airports. Takeoff, landing or spawning an airplane on the street is not allowed, even if your faction has placed an airplane garage. With a helicopter you can land wherever you want as long as you don't block other players. So, if you plan to land your helicopter on a highway or something like that, because you want to pick up something or whatever, just go to the side of the highway and not in the middle of the street. We have an air traffic control, or short ATC, on the server. You open it with Tab or on the Xbox controller X, and usually it shows the closest airport at the top of the list. Select the runway you want to take off or land and hit Enter. Make sure to land on the runway and keep the wheels on the ground until the drop-off. Do not fly or hop over to the drop-off. It does not matter if you select land or takeoff, but the runway needs to be reserved by you. You can see that when the runway is green, and when it's red, it's reserved by somebody else. The bigger the plane, the more ATC time you will have available for landing and takeoffs. You can move on the runway when it's blocked, but do not take off or land on any blocked runway. This rule exists so you don't crash into each other in the air, they regulate the speed of the job, and to give runways a sense. Keep that in mind because multiple breaks of these rules will result in a kick. It can happen that multiple people got clearance if they press at the same time, and for this reason and for more job speed consistency, we have the passive mode activated at all airports. If it happens that two players got the clearance at the same time, they can just do their business, either land or take off. Also, if you have a small airplane, then please, for the love of your God and all what is holy to you, please use the jet runway, especially in SSIA and Palito Bay. I see a lot of small airplanes taking a main runway, which is blocking off the bigger airplanes from taking off or landing, and then these players need to take an extra round. While it's not against the rules, it's just my request to you that you please pay attention to that. And before we start, let's go over some settings. We have multiple additional airports in the city. To see them, go to Escape Settings, Advanced Graphics, and turn high detail streaming while flying on. In the M menu, we have additional pilot settings in player options, piloting options. Most of the settings are self-explanatory. The one I want to mention here is the toggle flight radar hotkey. If you press that, you can activate the radar with the left alt key to see other airplanes or helicopters in your range. Always check the 8 menu when you are in an airplane. Some airplanes have additional upgrades and I usually max everything out. This change will be lost when you despawn the plane or disconnect. On some planes you can even choose different liveries. Alright, enough unimportant blah blah, more important blah blah. Airline pilot is a pretty straightforward job. Switch at the job center to the pilot job, buy a plane, spawn it at the airplane garage at any of the airports around the map, and start the mission at the blue marker. After you press E, the boarding will start and the next location will be shown. Head over to a runway, press Tab for the ATC menu and choose a runway for takeoff. To stop taking new passengers, open the M menu and select Stop Job. You can speed up the levering process not only with the EXP tokens, but also with complete meal or airline meals. This will give you a boost in payment, XP and bonus XP tokens. 15% for complete meals and 50% for airline meals. Complete meals are found in the treasure chest, or you can craft them at your property in the kitchen. You will need the components solid, water, alcohol and paste, which you receive when decomposing kebab, water bottles and vodka. Airline meals can be crafted with refrigerated or Liberty City trucking. For the food trucking, change at the trucker's HQ to refrigerated, I will never be able to pronounce that, and check F7 for the tour. I also will throw it up on the screen here. Let me know in the comments if you want a video on that, maybe I will string it together with some similar stuff. For Liberty City trucking, head over there at the job center and follow the export tour shown in screen now. At the last step, you will get Liberty City tokens and these you can exchange at the undercover storage. Keep in mind to always buy the highest level airplane available to get the most XP and check ttstats.eu if double XP events are going on. Well, right now we're only going on one server, so you probably will see that anyway. Under 800 feet there is slowdown, so after you take off, make sure you reach 800 feet or higher as fast as possible. You can see it in the clip here, how it's slowing me down if I go under 800 feet and as soon as I go higher, I'm able to speed up again. In Los Santos, in the big city, you're not allowed to fly lower than the Maze Bank Tower, which you can see here. It's the highest building, so keep it over 1300 feet if you fly over Los Santos. There are also some ambient airplanes. You will notice that they do not appear on the radar like player planes. The ambient airplanes do not land at any airport and will just cross the skies. With the Y button, you can activate autopilot, which will hold your current height and speed so you don't have to press W the whole time. On the airport, you can cut across grass, just keep in mind to keep the wheels on the ground. Alright, let's go over cargo pilot. When you swap to cargo pilot at the job center, buy the plane which is available for you at the dealership and head over to the yellow crate on the airport. Select the cargo you want to pick up and then open your trunk to load it. You can do that by either holding B and select trunk. The M menu, or even better with a keybind in the Fivem menu. Go to Escape, Settings, Keybinds, Fivem, and set a key on the vehicle trunk. It might look a bit more complex at first, as you can do different tours, but the fastest ones are between Senkudu Military, or short ZAN, and Chumash, or short CHU. There is also a bigger tour going from Senkudu to Mount Gordo Airport, to Palito Bay and back to Senkudu. Probably Senkudu Chumash is still the fastest way, but people have been debating this for some time and I'm not 100% sure myself, so I will leave it up to you to check them both out and decide for yourself. For Cargo Pilot, we only have the bonus EXP to boost our leveling, and keep in mind to always use the highest level cargo plane. So now, some of you maybe have the big question. What is better, airline or cargo? From a low level perspective, it really does not matter. When you have both airline jobs on maximum level and you have the biggest planes, then cargo will pay you around 1 million each trip, going from Senkudu to Chumash, and airline pilot with airline meals will give you between 650k and up to 1 million. It is really just depending on the current market price for XP tokens, because there lies the big cash. To get maximum tokens in Airline Pilot, you need to buy or craft airline meals, so you lose some time crafting instead of farming the tokens. And with cargo, you can just straight up start it and earn tokens, so there is really no good comparison between them. So what should I level first? You will get to a point where it will be mandatory to have both jobs leveled to buy bigger planes. The easy answer to this is, do what you like. Maybe you don't want to fly one day and you can do some airline meal trucking. Maybe there is a skill of the day bonus for train conductor and you want to do that. The options in Transport Tycoon are not endless, but you can always do something else to keep it fresh. For the last main aviation job, let's talk about helicopter pilot. As a helicopter pilot, you do not need to use ATC and you can also land wherever you want as long as you do not block any other players. So don't land in the middle of the highway or other busy places. After you swap to heli pilot at the job center, buy a helicopter in the aircraft dealership. And spawn it from a heli garage. You will see red helicopter symbols at the map and these are the starting points. It does not matter which one you choose as the game will give you a route depending on your helicopter, so always fly with the highest level helicopter you can buy. The tour itself is pretty straightforward. Sometimes in the city it can be hard to tell where you land as some minimap symbols may overlap, but after a few rounds you will get used to the drop-off places. You also don't need to land, you can just hover over the marker and press E and then continue to the next point. The money, XP and bonus XP token payment depends on the distance between the two stops. At the end of the tour, you will get a XP and XP token bonus, which is the sum of all stops. With helicopters, you can fly between buildings in the city and the Y button, aka the autopilot, also works in helicopter. The autopilot in heli is a little bit tricky though. You probably need to wiggle around a little bit to find the perfect position so you don't crash. The speed boost can also be applied to the helicopter. Just fly over it and press E when you get the prompt and your helicopter will be speed boosted. And this is where the big brain strategy comes into play. You will see the same strategy with train conductor, and these are the only two jobs which uses this strategy, so let's get into it. As heli pilot, you consume each stop the same amount of bonus XP tokens as you receive, and by the end you get bonus XP tokens on top of that. That means after some time you have a massive surplus of heli tokens which are not used. So that leaves us with some tokens which we can consume directly. But just consuming them each stop is not very effective, so what you do is the following. Farm and convert enough tokens so you are on a comfortable level of bonus XP tokens. I recommend around 3 to 5,000 so you have enough to continue normal leveling without grinding new tokens. Farm 4,000 EXP tokens and do not convert them to bonus XP. Make sure that you have at least 1,000 bonus XP in your inventory, and then redeem exactly 4,000 EXP tokens instead of converting them. You can put some tokens in your backpack or to the trunk if you have more than 4,000. The reason for this is that the game will not take more than 1,000 bonus XP token when you get experience, so you need to redeem exactly 4,000 to reach that. If you consume 4,010 token, you will still get the XP, but there is no bonus on top for the last 10 tokens, so keep that in mind. As an example, I'm using player tokens now because I don't have enough of the heli or train tokens. To maximize the strategy even further, get yourself some percentage EXP boost like the 10% Discord voice or different boosters around the map. Since you are gaining a big number of experience, the percentage of top is a pretty sick bonus. Check out my getting started and progress video if you wanna learn more about them. To finish off the aviation part of this video, I wanna mention there are a few other jobs which uses planes and helicopters, but I will go over them in another video as they are part of other jobs. Train conductor is probably one of the easiest jobs in Tycoon. You just need to swap to train conductor, and at the red markers you can spawn the trains. No cost at all. I will go over some basic train conductor tips and tricks, and then we will talk about each train conductor variant and what's the best strategy to level them up. After you spawn a train, keep driving to the starting point and hit E to start your tour. You don't need to brake for the start unless you also have a drop-off at that point. Stop at every point the game tells you to and then continue until you don't want to anymore. When you leave the train, it will despawn, so no cleanup needed either. I would recommend in trains to switch to first person view, as it does not mess around with your camera so much. The speed of the train locks in, so you don't need to press accelerate the whole time. Trains also don't jump out of the tracks, so you can drive with maximum speed the whole time. To quickly brake, you can use spacebar. For metro, you need to be at 10 km per hour or less, and for passenger trains, it's 40 km per hour and under. In the city, passenger trains are limited to 85 km per hour, but if you keep W pressed, you can get it up to 92 km per hour. Alright, now let's go over some train conductor jobs. The best strategy to level up train conductor is to start with metro. At level 1 you will only have the metro available anyway, and that is the best train until level 20. Forget about cargo train, you never heard or seen that. There is no difference in metro and metro NL besides an optical one. The Metro NL is the metro from the Netherlands. Collinsco Metro is locked to the same named company, Collinsco, so you would have to join us if you want to use the metro. At level 5, you can choose a larger metro, which will give you more XP and more tokens, and you will use that until level 20. After you hit level 20, it's time for passenger trains. For the passenger train, there are a few different ones, but the clear winner is the Shinkansen E7. It is the fastest train before level 100, and they all give the same amount of experience, so just go with the E7. And here you can also use the big brain strategy, even more efficient. With Train Conductor it's the same, but it's a bit faster because every stop you will get twice the amount of tokens which you use. So just as a small refresher, convert as many tokens to bonus XP as you feel comfortable with, 3 to 5,000 in my opinion, and then redeem EXP tokens when you get to 4,000. Make sure that you have at least 1,000 bonus EXP in the inventory and do not redeem more than 4,000 EXP tokens at once. And the best for last, cargo train. This is purely a visual thing. Yes, you get some tokens, but it is nowhere near the metro or passenger train. You don't get experience and only a small amount of money. Don't do it unless you feel like driving around in a cargo train just for fun. If you wanna find out how you can boost your base experience rate even more, as I said, check out my getting started and the progress guide. And that's it for now. Thank you all for taking your time to watch the video, and if you wanna support me, please have a look in the video descriptions. If you think like I missed something, or if you have other strategies, please leave a comment below. And thank you all for watching the video. Have a great day, everyone.